I started it with a partner of mine. We both were fresh postgraduates out of SIMBY, and we just were like crazy, like, we will do something and we shall achieve and we'll show them all. And this was in 2010 when internet wasn't that bombastic. I mean, it was just catching up, right? We had just finished the Orkut phase and we were coming into Facebook. I'm talking about back in the day. Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
So it wasn't very easy for your work to travel the world, but it was not so difficult that now you couldn't knock on doors. So I remember we did projects for MTV because we had seniors who were working in MTV. So it was very good to connect with our alumni. And that's a great tip, guys. If you ever feel you need to knock on doors, start with home. Start first with your own parents, cousins, family. If that doesn't work, go to your college level, school level, reach out to your alumni. That's worked wonders for me. It still does. When I have to reach out to guests for you know, our podcast, sometimes I just run short of like really good guests. I just reach out to my own alumni saying, please help, I need a guest this week. Come on, guys. And now luckily the podcast is a brand now, so they feel very privileged to come onto it. So I'm happy about that. But I've begged a lot as well, so it's okay. So anyway, moving back to this. So we did projects for MTV. We did projects for RBI, Grameen Kuta was their microfinancing organization. So we did script work for their films for third party. We worked for cultural films for the Karnataka government, the Tamil Nadu government, where we had a little easier access. Hence, it was these two governments we worked with. We also sent a lot of film representations to NASCOM. Wells Fargo was another bank that we pitched work to. Hamleys, acquired by Reliance. Again, we had a common connection there. So he was able to send us work because we were first timers and we were like, please give us an opportunity. And we got it. So there were a lot of really nice stories that happened this way. There were hundreds of others that we did. But one thing we realized with this, at least back in the day, was you need deep pockets to be in the media business. It is not that you produce today, you get your profits tomorrow. Now things have changed. It's a lot better with OTT coming in. But again, 2010, 2011 was not exactly that. You had to really put in your money, wait for 3-4 years to actually see any kind of returns and profits. So I learned it very fast in business that unless there's profit coming in, there's really no point being the founder and entrepreneur of any company. Because if you can't pay your staff, you can't pay yourself, you can't have a quality of life, it's really not worth it. I mean, all those, unless you have really good, now you have investors who are ready to invest in media companies. Back in the day, I'm sure there were investors, but